Okay, so now we're going to continue with the Johnny Legal Eagle series, where I'm just going to get down to business as if we were in a courtroom, court of law. I've already presented several videos to this point. Everything should build on itself. So I'll go back and number them one through whatever we end up doing, possibly five. That should wrap it up. But let me go back and read the thesis sentence from the last video. Part one is, if you are indeed an angel that is trapped in a world and that world is designed to slaughter sheep, then there should be outward manifestations that the conquering race exhibited or exhibits to show they were or are indeed the masters of the sheep, and the sheep serve as a food source. Okay, so the last video what I did was I showed you a lot of sheep that were being destroyed. We're going to review those in a very quick, very poignant way right now. And then we'll go into part two. And let me show you what part two is. Part two is the conquering race, the ones that are killing all the sheep, would also more than likely exhibit manifestations that also identified them as the rulers. And I showed you that the Bible says, those that rule my people mock them, says the Lord. And I showed you the outward manifestation of that mocking is right there in the Bible. They wink their eye and they stick out their tongue. Because when you wink the eye, you're showing that the all-seeing eye from the bottomless pit is what's looking at you, because we have one good eye and one bad eye. So if you shut one eye, the eye that's looking at you is the one from the bottomless pit. Okay, so unless you get converted, then you have two eyes that are the same. Your eyes become like twins, but they are directed from above. They are no longer one good, one bad, one from above, one from below. But if you're not converted and someone's not converted and they wink their eye at you, they're shutting one eye, and the eye that's looking at you is the eye from the bottomless pit, the all-seeing eye. Okay, if someone sticks their tongue out at you, that's Isaiah 57 verse 4. Against whom do you sport yourself? And that means, who are you mocking? Who are you making sport of? And sticking out your tongue, are you not the seed of falsehood, children of transgression? Okay, so those are the identifying characteristics of the enemy, and that's how their host body identifies them. If you're in their presence, they'll wink at you and they'll stick out their tongues. Sometimes they don't always do that. I also have a gift that's in 1 Corinthians 12 that's called the discerning of spirits. I've been around people for quite some time before I was able to completely discern the spirit I was dealing with. They weren't winking, they weren't sticking out their tongue, but you can tell every tree by its fruit. After a while, the fruit becomes obvious. Okay, now we're going to do a quick recap on, if we are indeed on a planet that is designed, or in a system, I'll just say a system, the Earth. By the way, the word Earth means decoration. If we are indeed in a system that is designed to kill and destroy sheep, then there should be an outward manifestation that the conquering race exhibits to show they are indeed the masters of the sheep, and the sheep serve as a food source. Let's go ahead and review those.
Can you tell me what's happening here?
Well, my sources are no longer fully annotated, and my information is somewhat anecdotal. But I believe what was once one race is now two. One above and one below. Two distinct species that have evolved.
And how do those below survive?
That is the real question, isn't it?
Killing sheep. Killing sheep. Killing sheep. Largest altar in the world. Dead sheep. Definitely a dead sheep. Picture of yours truly drawn by Alex at Starbucks. Dead sheep. Shopping bag from Zoomies in the mall. Dead sheep. Neighborhood watch sign for the entire United States. Dead sheep. Statue in downtown Grand Junction. Dead sheep. Tattoo of Eros and Psyche, an angel kissing a woman. Dead sheep. Tattoo of an angel linked to a demon. Dead sheep. Image of the Virgin de Guadalupe turned upside down. Dead sheep. Drawing done by a guy named Marcel at Jonathan Kleck's warehouse. Dead sheep. Bonus. Goat. Quick commercial break.
In a world that is bland, colorless, and cold, where banality grows like a fungus or a mold, there live the boring sheeple who look just like each other. A darker force rides into town, unleashing demon brothers. Here come the little deviants. They come from underground. They're rising from the depths to take those sheeple down. The sheeple are compliant and make for fine ingredients. For customizing anything, here come the little deviants.
Dead sheep. Hieroglyph of Akhenaten and Nefertiti, 1,300 years BC. Dead sheep. Child in hieroglyph that Akhenaten is holding. Dead sheep. H.R. Giger, the artist for the Alien movies, was Sigourney Weaver. Woman being inseminated. Dead sheep. Painting by George W. Bush at an art exhibit of a serviceman. Dead sheep. Presidential portrait of Barack Hussein, I am the Antichrist Obama. Yep, dead sheep. Aerial view of the Vatican and surrounding properties with the hidden key of Solomon made by the Vatican, the courtyard, and the mausoleum. Dead sheep. Slightly enhanced image of Nefertiti. Dead sheep. Dead sheep. Giant serpent face tattoo. Eye. Mouth of the serpent. Dead sheep. Drawing of the Virgin from a calendar. Yeah. Yep. A dead sheep. Pyramid from a museum in Guatemala. Dead sheep. Yep. Card given to Jonathan from his wife for constantly starting fights. Dead sheep. Dead sheep. Again. Children's waffle served to Jonathan and his daughters at Jim's restaurant in San Antonio. Dead sheep. St. Stephen's Cathedral. Dead sheep. Popcorn at the grocery store. Girl's winking her eye. Dead sheep. Largest altar in the world inside the Vatican. Dead sheep. Google Doodle. Turned upside down. Great white shark about to be a dead sheep. Still shot Rolling Stones video. Old man bleeding like a sheep. Keith Richards sitting on top of a dead sheep. Dead sheep. Precise layout of the grounds of the Capitol in Washington, D.C. A large bug. Mandibles of the bug. Close-up of mandibles of the bug. Statue in the dead center of the mandibles of the bug. Ulysses S. Grant in the center of the mandibles of the bug. Upside down on Ulysses S. Grant, dead sheep. Dead sheep. Completely unenhanced drawing of the layout of the Capitol. Mandibles of the bug. Heavy metal band, Thy Art Is Murder. Album name, Dear Desolation, Sheep, nursing off a wolf. Several different tattoos on a female's back of a Venus flytrap. Dead sheep. Dead sheep. Venus flytrap. Dead sheep. Compare and contrast view. Rotate. Dead sheep. Venus flytrap. Dead sheep. Heavily tattooed female Dead sheep. Black widow. Wicked. Dead sheep. Painting by Kehinde Wiley, same artist that did the presidential portrait of Barack Obama, holding a white woman's head cut off. Dead sheep. Dead sheep. Dead sheep. Image of the Virgin turned upside down. Dead sheep. Dead sheep. Affliction shirt, popular clothing line. Yep, dead sheep. Tattoo of a praying mantis. Dead sheep. Cleaned up drawing of tattoo with praying mantis. Dead sheep. Character from the movie Venom. Is that his tongue or is he eating a sperm? Straight on image of Venom's face. Sheep. Sheep. Black and white image of human twins. White sheep. Black sheep. Sheep. A guy standing at a coffee trailer drinking an espresso with a baby sheep that says, "End me." The back of the shirt with the baby lamb that says, "End me," says, "Seduced, accused, destroyed." Dead sheep. Seduced, accused, destroyed. Destroyed. Dead sheep. Celine Dion clothing line. Sheep. Crossbones. Skull and Bones Club. Dead sheep. Right side up, upside down. Movie Venom. Sheep. Sheep. Revelation 13. Venomous beast. Marina Abramović, famous Hollywood witch, hosts the Mocha Gala, carrying out a black sheep for the slaughter. Killing sheep. Complete body tattoo of a witch. Dead sheep. Dead sheep. Dead sheep. So, again, let's just go over that thesis sentence one more time for the last video. After doing that relatively quick, just recap. Okay, just very quickly. Just if we're laying out evidence for the courtroom. If you are indeed an angel that is trapped in a world, and the world is designed to slaughter sheep, then there should be an outward manifestation or outward manifestations that the conquering race exhibited or exhibits to show they were or are indeed the masters of the sheep, and the sheep serve as a food source. The next part is part two. The conquering race would also more than likely exhibit manifestations that also identified them as the rulers. So I'd also like to clarify very quickly one part of that statement, the part that's in parentheses, or the parts. If you are indeed an angel that is trapped in a world because you were led away captive, and that world is designed to slaughter sheep, which are represented by angels according to the largest altar in the world, then there should be outward manifestations that the conquering race exhibited or exhibits to show they were or are indeed the masters of the sheep. So, just to qualify that one more time, the largest altar in the world is indeed a large dead sheep. This was hidden from everybody's view until recently when the Lord revealed it to myself, when he revealed it to me. And he told me to take a very close look at it. It's very obviously a sheep. I'll make it very obviously a sheep for you by simply cropping the image and show you that the image of the angels make the wool of the sheep. And then I'll put it side by side with a sheep. And then we're going to move on into part two. There you go. So obviously the snoot of the sheep, the snoot of the sheep, eye of the sheep, eye of the sheep, eye of the sheep, eye of the sheep. Ear of the sheep, ear of the sheep, ear of the sheep, ear of the sheep. Teeth, tongue sticking out. So now we've clearly identified, and we have not just identified, we've absolutely proven that there's an agenda for destruction of sheep, whether or not it's built into architecture of buildings, whether or not it's in tattoos where there's hidden images of sheep with an agenda of angels and demons linked together, and or an angel kissing a woman, and a sheep is being destroyed in both cases. Whether or not it's in a mausoleum is where you keep dead people. The entire building is built as a dead sheep. The entire Vatican, by the way, Vatican means divining serpent, the entire Vatican itself, which means divining serpent, is a big serpent wearing a crown. The altar that you're looking at, the window above this dead sheep, is the mouth of the serpent. Therefore, the serpent eats what? Sheep. What is the cumulative sum of the sheep made of? Angels. Jesus said, do not your own scriptures say, I said ye are gods, Elohim, angels. He quoted Psalm 82, I have said you are Elohim, angels, but you shall die like men. So if you're an angel, how do you die like a man? Well, you have to become a man first. How does that happen? Well, you have to fall from heaven to become a man, don't you? Because if you are an angel, that means you are in heaven. So the only way to become a man is you have to be kicked out of heaven or leave heaven for some reason. It's exactly what the Bible says. So here is a perfect drawing that I've simply colored in for your perception to make it very simple. I'll start with this image first just to show you the top of the altar. I'll enlarge it. It's high pixelation, very clear. There's a bunch of angels. I colored them blue. These things that are supposed to be clouds are not clouds. It's semen. The spirit of Elohim moved over the semen. Those are angels, and the word Elohim means angels. The spirit of Elohim moved over the semen. Genesis 1 verse 2. Showed it to you in the last video. So, it looks like the Bible is exactly correct. Let's get down to the bottom of the altar now, where they've all melted, and there they are flowing into semen. There's a bunch of angels in blue, and they're flowing. See how it's all flowing like honey, and they're all turning into semen. Now it's time to see who's actually running the show. Who are they slaves to, and what is the source that is benefiting from the destruction of all the angels, aka sheep? Because some source is benefiting quid bono, so who is getting that benefit? But let's read the scriptures first. And the spirit of Elohim, angels that are of the supreme God, the spirit of angels moved upon the face as the part that turns of the waters semen. Genesis 1:26. And God, the cumulative sum of angels and magistrates of the supreme God, said, let us make man in our, very important word, selim, a phantom, that is figuratively an illusion, resemblance, hence a representative figure, especially an idol. If anyone thinks that's God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost, unfortunately, they're delusional. God the Father and God the Son does not have a female spirit. God the Father and God the Son has a male spirit. The spirit of the world, the opponent of the Lord God, is a female spirit. Wisdom is defined as female. Be as wise as a serpent, but as gentle as a dove. So, if anyone's trying to make the argument that because wisdom is female, you'd have to also make the argument that being as wise as a serpent, you'd have to make the argument that the spirit of the serpent is the Holy Spirit, which is completely incorrect. That's why it doesn't say she. That's why virgins turn into dead sheep when you turn the virgin upside down. But you would have to know that. So God created man in his own vain show, in the vain show of Elohim, the cumulative sum of God's angels and magistrates, created he him, that's Lucifer, male and female created he them. So those that took the bait went with him, and male and female created he them. Those that were foolish enough to side with him. Okay, so now we've shown you all a lot of sheep, and we've shown you the same agenda. Whether or not it's in downtown Grand Junction with a serpent strangling a sheep, that's a girl kissing a guy, which is male and female, or whether or not you're looking at the largest altar in the world, which is a dead sheep, which is male, and when you turn it upside down, it's female. There you go. So, the largest altar in the world is male and female. Well, that's perfect, because Elohim said, let us create man in his own vain show, male and female created he them. Just like the statue in downtown Grand Junction. Male and female, serpent. Vatican, male and female, serpent. Doesn't take a big brain to figure this out. The data's right there in front of you now. Anyone that would argue with it would be delusional. Delusional is characterized by the definition. It means holding on to your own idiosyncratic belief, that means personal belief, even when you're presented with evidence to prove to the contrary. I'm giving you perfect evidence that proves the serpent. Inside of the serpent, the mouth of the serpent is male and female, which is the food source for the serpent and its angels that are as sheep. I'm showing you the identical agenda in downtown Grand Junction which is a male and a female kissing, and there's a serpent strangling and killing a sheep. I've shown you the same agenda, I didn't count the number of times, but do you see a lot of dead sheep? Virgin, turn it upside down, dead sheep. Virgin, turn it upside down, dead sheep. Hieroglyph of Akhenaten Nefertiti, turn it upside down, dead sheep. Guatemalan pyramid, turn it upside down, dead sheep. Picture of Jonathan Kleck. Jonathan said that guy will draw a picture of me with the dead sheep, and he did. Dead sheep. Went to my warehouse. Marcel. Hey, I drew me only Jonathan Yulogarce para ti. He made an image of me with the dead sheep. Girls with tattoos, with insects hatching out of a dead sheep. The movie Venom. Two big sperm as eyes and a dead sheep in the middle, and on it goes. This is no longer arguable by anyone that's got a functioning brain or isn't demonically possessed. So now, let's move on to who is running the show. Who is destroying all the dead sheep? Well, we're going to look at that altar because the altar shows us clearly who's destroying the sheep. But let me show you four quick pictures very quickly before I go into that. I want to show you the Miley Cyrus video I showed you in the last video. Let me show you a couple pictures real quick. Let's see. Oh, that's the march after Trump was elected president. They wore their pink hats. They called them their pussy hats. This girl wrote, "This pussy bites back," and she put teeth on a vagina. There's Miley Cyrus, and at two points of her video, she showed her vagina with teeth on them when she said, "I got the power." There's a scene from Scooby-Doo where Scooby-Doo and Shaggy are pinned up on the wall by sausages and turkeys that look suspiciously like labia that open up, and a prehensile mouth comes out. And there's a bag from Zoomies. It's a skateboard shop in the mall that has the identical agenda. And what I did was, just to prove it's a real thing, there it is. And you can see quite clearly a door, like a dimension in space, and coming out of that door is what looks like a worm with a mouth open that's got teeth, and there's sperm swimming right into the mouth. And at the bottom of the bag, the end of the cycle is an egg that's cracking, it hatches, and then it's a dead sheep, and it's part of the equation. By the way, I've pretty much figured out this whole equation, and I can go through it, but for purposes of tonight, there you go. So, isn't it fascinating that Miley Cyrus has a vagina with teeth on her? Isn't it fascinating that the march against Donald Trump, the pussy hat march, not one, but many women had vaginas that had teeth on them? That would suggest that their vaginas in some way are cannibalistic, which is not far from the truth, because that was the source in which the other side was able to exit the pit and begin the system that turned into the self-cannibalizing system. There's a picture from the Scooby-Doo scene I just showed you, and I wonder why a turkey would be on the wall. Unless they're just really using it as a double for a vagina and sausages for penises, which are what strapped them to the wall so that they could be killed by the turkeys with the large jaw that comes out of the turkey breast, which makes all kinds of sense. The funny thing was, right when they get pinned to the wall, the scene says, "And now for the main course, you." While sausages hold them captive, sausages hold them captive. And while turkey breasts open up with a mouth and teeth, no different than Miley Cyrus's vagina in her movie Mother, Sister, or whatever it is. Anyway, let's go ahead and move on. Okay, so I'd like to show you something that occurs in nature, just to kind of get your mind in the right place. This is a jewel wasp, and what it does is it stings a cockroach, it puts a seed on it, and then the larva eats it from the inside out. There it is, grabbing it. There it is, injecting the seed. And now the cockroach has had a seed implanted in it by a bug that stung it and implanted the seed inside of it. Oh, death, where's thy sting? Now the cockroach has a larva attached to it. This is no different than the hieroglyph of Akhenaten and Nefertiti, where the head of the child that Akhenaten's holding has a dead sheep in the head, as well as a reptile. This is no different than a Guatemalan pyramid that shows a dead sheep with a devil imprinted over the face. This is no different than the largest altar in the world, which is a dead sheep, which is the male and female reproductive system. And what I'm about to show you is, when you come back from that altar, the entire thing turns into a large insect with the mandibles right where the vagina is. So the chair that's the penis is going into the mandibles of a bug. Therefore, the bug would be harvesting whatever's coming out of the chair, which is semen, which turned into a penis. So a large bug, which is the largest altar in the world, is harvesting semen as a source of energy. Now, just for the record, at the end of the world, there's the beginning of the world, then there's the end of the world. The end of the world is the end of a cycle, like a breeding cycle. And at the end of that cycle, guess what happens? The pit opens up. There is a large earthquake, and the sun and the air are darkened by reason of the smoke of the pit. And out of the smoke, there came locusts upon the earth, insects, and they have tails like scorpions. And they will sting men, and men will seek death and will not find it. They will desire to die, and death will flee from them. And the reason is because since the beginning of the world, these creatures that have been breeding using the host body system as an illusion, because it looks like, oh, wow, this is what's normal. We're male and female. We get married. We have babies and everything's cool. No. It's just a breeding system to open up what's coming up out of the pit. And all the angels that made the mistake and got cast down and thrown into this system become part of that cycle that's breeding a race of locusts, scorpions from the pit. That's what this whole earth is all about. The Bible says in the end, everything secret will be made public. That's what I'm doing, is I'm showing you. I'm a harbinger. I'm a servant of the Most High. And I've given you all the data to prove it. And also the Lord's let me have supernatural gifts to prove that I work for him. I've laid hands on people that are blind. Their sight's recovered. I've laid hands on people with incurable diseases. They recovered immediately. These signs will accompany those that believe on my name. They'll lay hands on the sick and they'll recover. They'll cast out demons. They'll do many works in my name. All those signs have accompanied the person that's speaking to you, just for the record. Other people that are claiming that the Holy Spirit is female, I don't know so much about that. Just being very direct. I don't like it when I see people teaching heresy. I don't care if they're my friend or not. By the way, you should never take money ever. You should never sell the Word of God. If you want to live off donations from people, that's one thing. But to be like people I know, like Steve Quayle and other people I know, that sell gold and silver, K-rations, books. They're merchandising the Word of God. The Bible says, as you freely receive, freely give. So you, whatever knowledge the Lord gives to you, you should give away for free. You shouldn't charge for it. I don't charge for it. If anybody wants to support us because they feel, hey, I want to support this ministry, that's great. Otherwise, everything's free. Never charge one thing. Not one dime ever. Just donations. That's it. Because then it's the Lord God taking care of you, using who He chooses to support you. And it's not them, it's Him through them supporting His own people. But when you sell books, gold and silver, K-rations, subscriptions, then you're merchandising the Word of God. They preach the Word for filthy lucre's sake. They're disingenuous. So here's the bug that's benefiting off the other one that's the host. No different than several images I've shown you so far, which we will look at in a little bit further in further detail. There it is. And it is using the other insect as a host. Then at an appropriate time, it begins and it hatches, and then it comes out of the host that it used, and it hatches, and the host has served its purpose. And here comes the new creature. All right, so now let's talk about part two. Who is responsible for all these dead sheep? What is the source? Now, I told you, we know that there's going to be a race that hatches from the pit. They're going to come up out of the pit, so the earth is almost like an egg that's going to hatch. The entire earth itself is going to hatch, and when it does, what's coming out of the earth? The pit. Insects. So it would stand to reason that insects are the ones that are benefiting off the sheep. Let's have a look. There's the largest altar in the world right there. I've simply zoomed out, and the light that's in the mandibles of this large bug right here is the window above the head of the sheep. That's the mouth of the serpent. So let's just go ahead and take an image of a bug's face and put it right there. And if you were going to make some architecture to resemble a bug, that is one hell of a job, don't you think? Look at that. That is one hell of a job to make the architecture mimic the head of an insect. Huh. Well, now I'd like to draw it in for you and just give you a little bit of coloring to make the perception even easier. So I've colored it green. I've made the eyes blue and yellow, just outlining. And there you go. And there's the whole thing. And then the chair that's called the chair of St. Peter is going in the mouth of the bug. That's actually a penis. So the one that would be responsible for the harvesting of the semen, which is, when you really get down to it, every sperm that fertilizes an egg becomes a soul. So it's really eating souls. Because the sperm is just the smallest particle of the beginning of the system. So when you take one sperm and one egg and you put them together, that's one soul over here. So if you're eating sperm, you're eating souls, which are angels. We know that because the word spirit in Romans 8 says, and as Ephesians 2, when you walked according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit, superhuman angel, demon, and the demon is what got mixed together with the angel, so it's in one system and it's self-cannibalizing. Therefore, if the angel doesn't get reconciled back to God, by the way, the word reconciled by definition means to reconcile. The Bible says, be reconciled to God through Christ. Well, you can't be reconciled to anybody that you didn't know previously or have an intimate relationship. By definition, the word reconcile means to restore relationships that were broken, like to kiss and make up, reconciled to one who you broke up with. So you cannot be reconciled to anyone that you weren't intimately involved with anyway. So the only way to be reconciled back to God is if you're an angel. There's no other way. Because when you're born a sinner. If you're born a sinner, in order to be back in touch with God, you have to be born again. So by definition, you can't be reconciled to God unless you're born again. That means when you come into the system, you're already separated from God from the moment you're born. So the only way, by definition, to be reconciled to God is you had to be an angel first, by definition. Because you start in this system as a sinner. So the only space of time you could even be in where you knew God intimately is before you got here. Because you're born separated from God. You're born a sinner. That's why you have to be born again. So if you're born a sinner, sometime down your lifeline is, you know, 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, 5 year, 6 year, and you reach 20, 30 years old, well, then you get reconciled to God because you get born again. So you had to be an angel to be reconciled to God. Because you can't be reconciled to God. You couldn't have known God until you get born again. So it's impossible by definition. And I'm an ambassador of reconciliation. I'm here looking for interdimensional beings that are lost in a system called the flesh. And I'm trying to get you to go home by accepting the truth. Jesus is the truth. By confessing your sins, admitting your guilt before God, and asking for forgiveness. And through faith, by grace, you are saved. And you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Perfect logic, flawless. It's not mine, it's the Lord's. Let's look what happens to a human in a slave collar. This is part of the Catholic Church. This is called the List of Popes. Now, it would seem to me that if there is a church and that church right down here has a list of everyone that's ever been a pope, and this is the list right here. There's this thing right down here at the bottom. I'm going to show you what it is. That's the kind of the trophy wall for being a pope. Well, if the pope is the head of the church that is an insect that feeds on angels, a.k.a. sheep, a.k.a. semen, well, it would seem that the pope is a mouthpiece for that leader that's an insect. And it'd have to be, by definition. So, I find it very interesting that this is the bottom of this right here that I just showed you. I want to enlarge the other one, and then I'll take this one with it. I'll enlarge the list of popes, and then I'll take this with it and just show you where it goes. So this is what's right there. So I'm going to put that right there and show you. That's what's right there. So the head guy that runs this institution at various times, he gets his name on this plaque with this thing right here at the bottom of the plaque. So let me show you what that is, because I told you just like the jewel wasp needs a host, the other side, the evil realm of darkness, they need a host as well. Why do you think the Bible calls the Lord of hosts? Because the enemy had created a host body system to lure angels into sinning against God, their creator, and then they get caught in a host body system. Host body system, host. And if they don't get converted and stop that process of self-cannibalization, then they will become no different than the roach in the video I just showed you. They will be something that the host uses to hatch their young from the pit. But what goes to the pit is your soul. Just because you can't see it is the reason they're getting away with it. Did you know that's why they, in Genesis 1:26, it says, let us create man in our vain show, illusion, phantom image, representative figure, especially an idol. Anyone who thinks that's the Lord Gaia is delusional. Anyone that thinks that's the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit is delusional. No, that's Satan and the fallen angels saying this is how we're going to take out God's angels. That's why in Ezekiel it says, and in Isaiah 14, thou hast said in thine heart, thou wilt arise above the throne of the Most High, El. Not Elohim. Elohim is the apostates, are the apostates. So let's take a look at, again, I'm going to take this image right here. That's right there. Let's see what's on the, what do you get from being on that thing? Well, first thing I'm going to do is color it in for your perception. And let me show you what an angel's host is. The angel's host is a human body. So the angel gets trapped in this thing. It's a, called a human body, man. And this is a big slave collar on him. And these things that I've colored green, these are different. This is a fetus here, and this is a fetus here. And they both have umbilical cords going to different sides of this human's head. But what's trapped inside is an angel, because this is simply a host. These are everlasting chains of darkness, as mentioned in Jude. I'll show it to you, just so you know exactly what I'm saying is true. Jude, it's only one chapter. And angels right there that left their first estate, which kept not their first estate, which is their beginning, which is their commencement in heaven, because angels are created by God. And angels which kept not their first estate, but left their own habitation, he has reserved in everlasting, forward and backwards. Chains under darkness. Chains is a band, that is a ligament of the body, shackle of a prisoner. So your chains of darkness are your ligaments of your body. And this is a representation of all the angels that got caught in host bodies. And you have two different fetuses, one going to each side of your head, showing your dualistic nature. The Bible says, cleanse your hearts, you double-minded. That's why there's two fetuses with umbilical cords going to separate sides of this guy's head. Now we're going to take a little bit closer look at the slave collar that's enslaved him. And I'm going to play for you. We're going to do a Jaguar commercial. Here is a slave collar right here. Now I've just simply drawn in a little more for your perception. This is my spiritual gift. It's supernatural. There you go. There's the slave collar. The slave collar is a beast. There's the eye. Let me move that little banner. There's the eye. There's the eye. There's the nose. There's the fang. There's the fang. There's the tongue. So they have created a beast. Satan and the fallen angels. They've created a beast system. You get an angel and a demon trapped in a host body, and you got a beast system. That beast is just waiting to get off the leash, and that comes at the end of the cycle. Once the beast is unleashed, by the way, the word beast in Revelation 13 is venomous beast. That's why there's a movie called Venom, and he's got two sperm as eyes, because that represents the seed of the devil and the seed of Adam. Venomous beast. You get it? That's why the negative space I showed you on his forehead was a dead sheep. Okay? So, here's the beast system. Now I'm going to show you a commercial.
It's time for a change. A new plan needs a new boss. It's time for something more surprising, more British, the Jaguar.
We've already created a beast.
Now
Already created a beast. Already created a beast.
Now it's time for a new animal.
With the same potent DNA, but even...
We've already created a beast, and now it's time for a new animal. Is this selling you a car or something? No. It's an agenda. We've already created a beast. Now it's time for a new animal, even more ruthlessly efficient, using the same potent DNA. Well, I've told you repetitively that the pyramids and those that built the pyramids are your enemy. And that's why right when they say that, they make sure the triangle shadow is right over Tom Hiddleston's eye. See the triangle right there? All-seeing eye. We've already created a beast. Now it's time for a new animal using the same potent DNA. What DNA are they talking about? The all-seeing eye, the DNA from the pit. That's what they're talking about. So let's listen to that again.
We've already created a beast.
Now it's time for a new animal.
With the same potent DNA, but even more ruthlessly efficient.
Unleash the cats.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, right away.
Go on, my pretty ones, go on. Go on.
Go forth and rule the roads!
Oh yes, it is good to be bad.
Okay, so I don't know how many of you actually believe that is a commercial for a jet, for a car, but then I would probably have to tell you you're delusional. It's not, we've already created a beast. Now it's time for a whole new animal, more ruthlessly efficient. Well, let me show you what animal they're talking about that's more ruthlessly efficient. They're going to sting men. Men will seek death and will not find it. Just like the jewel wasp stinging the guy. Well, what happens when you simply turn this guy upside down? And we'll put it right here. Well, what comes out of the pit? And just to make sure you understand what I'm talking about, let's go ahead and open up Revelation 9. Insects are coming out of the pit. What's the largest altar in the world? It's angels being destroyed by insects. Oh, now everything makes sense. Revelation 9. And the fifth angel sounded, and I saw a star fall from heaven and unto the earth, and to him. It's not a blazing star, it's an angel. I saw a star fall from heaven unto him was given the key to the bottomless pit, and he opened the pit. And there arose smoke out of the pit as the smoke of a great furnace, and the sun and the air were darkened by reason of the smoke of the pit. There came out of the smoke locusts upon the earth. Unto them was given power as the scorpions of the earth have power. And it was commanded that they should not hurt the grass or the trees or any green thing, but only those men that have not the seal of God in their foreheads. And it was given that they should not kill them, but that they should be tormented 5 months. I wonder how long it took a jewel wasp to hatch its young inside that roach. They should be tormented 5 months, and their torment was as the torment of a scorpion when it strike the man. In those days men shall seek death and shall not find it. They shall desire to die, and death will flee from them. The only way that's possible is if you're incapacitated. The shapes of the locusts were like horses preparing unto battle. They had crowns of gold. Their faces were like the faces of men. Let's go to these pictures. Okay, well, turn it upside down. He's got the face of men. He's got the hair like a woman. If I colored these teeth in gold, it's a crown of gold. It's got hair like a woman. It's got teeth like lions. And it's got wings. Let's see what it says here. They had the faces of men. They had the hair of women. Wow, we're batting 1,000. And their teeth were as the teeth of lions. Wow, let's take a look at those. Yeah, those are pretty damn big mandibles, aren't they? And they had breastplates as it were breastplates of iron. And the sound of their wings. And this guy just happens to have wings as well. And the sound of their wings was as the sound of many chariots and horses running into battle. And they had tails like unto scorpions. And the stings were in their tails. And they had the power to hurt men 5 months. You know, oddly enough, I can show you. I have plenty of albums with plenty of information. But isn't it fascinating that the band The Scorpions, they have a female, again, by the way, the Catholic Church prays to the Virgin. They worship the Virgin, and when you turn the Virgin upside down, it's a dead sheep, which is the same as the largest altar in the world. Isn't it fascinating that the female has a stinger like a scorpion? And they sent to scorpions, and the stings were in their tails. And they had the power to hurt men 5 months. And they had a king over them, which is the angel of the bottomless pit, whose name in Hebrew tongue is Abaddon, but in the Greek tongue hath the name Apollyon. And again, I've told you repetitively that the angel of the bottomless pit, the name Apollyon, is simply Satan. And I'll prove it. Apollyon, Greek 6:23, is Satan. So who has a king over them that's name is Satan? Insects. Scorpions have a king named Satan. Have y'all started putting all this together now? Angels get consumed by insects from the pit, turned into food, lured away with a host body system that you can occupy, have sex, do whatever you want, and be co-creators with Lucifer. Oh yeah, you can share my kingdom with me. No, wrong. You're going to be food for me and my race that's coming out of the pit. Perfection in data. By the way, the Holy Spirit's not female. The enemy's female. A female spirit is the enemy. So they had a king over them with his name in Hebrew tongue is Abaddon, and Greek tongue has the name Satan. Okay? Now let's go back. Now remember in Jude, in the book of Jude, the everlasting chains of darkness in Jude 1, remember the angels that went after strange flesh, right? And angels which kept not their first estate, and left their own habitation, he has reserved in everlasting chains. Look, forward and backwards ligaments of the body. Let me show you a little picture. You see, let me show you this. This is a really great picture. See the F facing one way and the F facing the other way. And it's also making like a twin system that are opposed to each other, forward and backwards. And then they put the apple here with the serpent and a hook, like a fishing hook, showing the fall, because they knew that was the bait. That's a great image. An apple, you know, representing the fruit. The fruit wasn't an apple. It was host bodies. There you go. Let me show you a couple more telling images right here. I wonder how the serpent got out. I wonder how he, got his thing going on the surface. That's a pretty good image right there. There's another one. Wonder why people would get that tattooed on them. I wonder why Miley Cyrus has teeth on her vagina. I wonder why Azumi's bag has teeth on a vagina coming out of a dimension in space. I wonder why someone would draw a dead sheep on my face. I got a lot of questions. I wonder why the largest altar in the world is a dead sheep made up of a bunch of angels melting into semen. Let's keep exploring. So there's a locust coming out of the pit. So now we pretty much established those that want to kill the angels and eat the angels are really a race of insects from the pit that set a host body trap. It's pretty obvious, right? Thus saith the Lord of hosts. So now we have a lot of evidence starting to stack up. And so now what we're going to do is we're going to zero in on that statement from earlier and see what part two is. And we're just going to nail that thing to the ground now. If you are indeed an angel that is trapped in a world and the world is designed to slaughter sheep, then there should or would be outward manifestations that the conquering race exhibited or exhibits to show they were or are indeed the masters of the sheep. The conquering race would also more than likely exhibit manifestations that also identify them as the rulers. Well, let's see. What's one identifying characteristic? Well, the whole damn altar is a big bug harvesting semen. That's pretty identifiable. There's another colored image. That's funny. The largest church in the world that claims to be Christian, the leaders of that church get their name on a plaque with some poor bastard that's in a slave collar that looks like he's in complete and utter agony. Let me show you a picture of that without me drawing on it. That's just really, that's, so if you're a man of the cloth for this religion, that's what's under your name right there. I can see exactly what that is. Those are two feet. Look at the umbilical cord right here. Look at the umbilical cord. Look at it. That's an umbilical cord. That's a fetus. That's a fetus. That's an umbilical cord. This guy's in complete agony. By the way, there's not a lot of people that have foreheads that look like this. That's a very, that looks more like a plate on his head. That's because it's really an insect when you turn it upside down. And that's obviously a beast with its mouth open. And those are wings. Let's look at those braids. Look at those chains. That's kind of a very funky design on that. Isn't it? That's because those are really wings. And those are scales on a wing like a dragonfly. Very obvious. Once you know what's going on. So anyway, that's the image that is under the list of popes. And because they're the leaders of that system that turns angels into insects. That's why they're on that carved piece of marble right there. There you go. Well, here's another fascinating image right here. This is Eros and Psyche. And again, an angel, I'll enlarge it so you can really see the angel's face. The angel is sideways right here and he's kissing a female. But that led to the death of the sheep. See, angel, sheep. No different than the largest altar in the world. So, an angel kissing a female is the death of the angel. It turns to a dead sheep, which is exactly what the largest altar in the world is. Angels turning into a dead sheep. So now the perfection in data is not arguable. It is completely unarguable. Now let's start to really zero in on the rulers and the killers of the sheep that are using, obviously, a religion that worships the virgin, which is female, by the way, because the female spirit is that which destroyed the other one, the male. That's why they created them male and female. Self-cannibalizing. Yep. Okay. So now we're going to start zeroing in on the insect race that is destroying all of the angels by sex. And now let's just be very plain. The thing you're going to see a common denominator again of is no different than this large altar of a bug harvesting semen. I'm going to take this bug right here and I'm going to slide it up here and I'm going to show you right here. That chair right there that I'm enlarging, that chair, shooting, that's going into the mouth of a bug. So all that semen is really going into the mouth of a bug because I'm simply taking the bug and I'm putting the light where the window is right there. And the whole thing, that chair right there is a penis. And so the bug is harvesting semen. It's really no different. It's really no different than the Jewel Wasp, and a host. The only thing about this that's different is it's really kind of invisible because you can't really see it because it's spiritual. Oh, is that why it says in Genesis 1:26 and 1:27, let us create man in our phantom image? Oh, yeah, now it makes sense. Let us create man in our illusion. Because, see, the male-female host body system is an illusion. What's going on behind the scenes is what's really the reality. Now, let me talk to you about truth for a second. If you don't live in the truth, that means you're delusional by definition. Because truth is when fact equal reality. So if you haven't come to the knowledge of the truth, you're simply delusional. But you think that you're walking around, you know what's going on, but you don't. Arise, O sleeper, wake up from the dead, and Christ will give you light. So all you're doing is walking around in total darkness until you get converted. You see what I mean? Once you just take the logic and the definitions and the revelation gift that the Lord God gave me to give you, you can't argue with it. Otherwise, you're delusional. That's what the Bible says. The Bible even says in Matthew 13, to you it has been given to understand the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven. To them it has not been given. And the disciples said, why do you speak in parables? And he says, fulfilling the words of Isaiah, the prophecy of Isaiah, that they by seeing don't see, and they by hearing don't hear, neither can they understand. So see, I can show this to people that are delusional all day long, and they still don't get it. Just like you have friends and family. You can show it to them all day long. They don't care. Oh, you can see whatever you want. They can come up with whatever they reason they want for it. But it doesn't matter. It's always the same. Always the same. Every time. So let's continue. So this is a video by DeAntword. And I think this guy sums it up really well when he says this is what it is. I'm big in bread, fuck fast. Okay, and I'm just putting it in, you know, you'll have to excuse me, but I'm just being very clinical here. It's one big inbred fuckfest is what he said. And this is DeAntword Fatty Fatty Boom Boom. And then she's in front of this thing that says evil thing. It's male and female. But then what's really fascinating is a Lady Gaga impersonator runs into a doctor.
I've just been having the weirdest fucking day. First I got hijacked, and now there's something really funny going on down there. I think I might have picked something up.
By the way, on the wall behind it is supposed to be like mother and child, Madonna and child. And when he pulls this thing out of her vagina, I'm sorry, but it splats mucus on the face of a lion because they're taking a cheap shot at the lion of the tribe of Judah because they're birthing their locust race. And they're throwing this mucus on his face just to spite him because they hate Jesus, by the way. Now, I'm going to pause it again. When he reaches down and pulls the locust out of her vagina, because we know locusts are coming out of the pit, that's the reason he's going to pull a locust out of her vagina, it makes a noise. It makes a very high-pitched squeak. And the reason is because in Genesis 4, the word Cain, you know, which is where all this locust thing got started, really, that was the first child where the serpent was birthed on the surface. The serpent was birthed out of the pit onto the surface. The first child right there, his name was Cain. The word Cain means to strike fast and to strike a musical note. That's why when they pull a locust out of her vagina right now, it makes a musical note. That's the only way. None of this would make any sense unless you knew the truth, unless I knew the truth. No one could understand what the hell is this all about. I know exactly what it's about, because the truth lives in me. Listen closely.
Oh my God.
And then she says, oh my God, Elohim. Yeah, oh my God. Because that's the new God that's coming out of the pit. Right there, a locust. Otherwise, I'm willing to listen to your explanations if someone thinks they have one. But I can assure you, you don't. None that's accurate. That's exactly what it is. I just told you what it is. So, there you go. Birthing a locust, and it's got its own musical note.
Oh my God!
Okay. It's probably enough of that. Let's keep moving. So, again, who are the masters of the sheep that are being destroyed? Well, I told you, it's an insect race birthing from the pit, and they eat semen. Because semen is the most basic component of the human condition. That's why it's on Izumi's bag. That's why it's in Scooby-Doo. That's why Miley Cyrus. By the way, Miley Cyrus is one of her favorite facial expressions is sticking out her tongue, winking her eye. Both manifestations in the Bible of those that hate Jesus. Winking the eye and sticking out her tongue. She does them both. And she's got teeth on her vagina. And that's the same thing as Scooby-Doo. Okay, let's continue. Okay, so let me just quiz you real quick. What comes out of the pit? Scorpions. And the stings were in their tails. And their power was to hurt men 5 months. So, just think about this picture you're looking at for a sec. What's it imply? Well, see, he thinks he's having sex with some hot chick. But what he's really having sex with is a scorpion. What looked really great was just bait. That's all. So now, before I move further into the reality that the masters of the sheep is a race of insects from the pit, before I move further into that, I want to make a couple points about reality. If you're living in reality, here's some reality for you. That's a bag from the mall that shows something coming out of a dimension eating sperm, and then it's got an egg cracking and a dead sheep missing its head at the end of the cycle. And just so you know, I'll turn it on this side where I haven't colored it in. And that's one thing they count on, that the black and white doesn't really do anything for your brain. But coloring it in makes it very obvious. Now I'm going to show you a common denominator. Having shown you that, I'm going to show you again this short clip from Scooby-Doo. And they're on Spooky Island. And the truth of the whole Scooby-Doo movie, if you want to know the truth, just watch Scooby-Doo 1. It's all in there. Host bodies taken over by demons, turned into something else. Held hostage. Ready? Listen very carefully.
Green room!
For the main course. You!
So now I'm going to turn the volume off now. Now for the main course. You. Now, they're trapped. Their bands, what's made them prisoner, are sausages. Let's just think phallic. What made them a prisoner was a sausage. Euphemistically, a penis. Now, what's going to kill them? Well, this turkey breast is... Turkey breasts don't usually hang out stuck to walls. And the turkey breast opens up, and what's going to be the main course that's going to kill them is coming out of the turkey breast. I'm going to pause that. And there you go. So now what's trying to get him... Now, can anybody tell me in any way, shape, or form is what you're looking at right there, is what you're looking at on your screen, is that any different than the Zoomies bag? I'll put it next to it. It's no different. What's this coming out of? Well, let's just be honest. It's coming out of a turkey breast, which looks just like labia on a female. Now, let's just take that down and slide that down on Miley Cyrus. Is there any difference? So Miley Cyrus has teeth right there where her vagina is. So she's got teeth right there where her vagina is. I'll take this and I'll put it right there. That's the agenda, folks. That's it. That's what the male and female host body systems were used for, as a transfer of energy. It is the most elaborate, well-hidden transfer of energy mechanism ever conceived. What looks like life is really death. What looks like some wonderful thing is really a nightmare. What you try and hold on to, you will surely lose. That's why whoever loses his life, Jesus said, for my sake and the kingdom of heaven, will find eternal life. Will gain life and have eternal life. Whoever loves the world or the things of the world does not have the love of God in them. Now you know why. Because the world is an illusion. The whole damn thing is one big, really nifty sausage party. That's exactly what it is. You know, that's why Seth Rogen did a movie called Sausage Party. Go watch the trailer for it. I've broken it down, but I don't want a codec violation. I broke it down. It's the most obvious thing in the world. It's everything I'm showing you. So there's Miley Cyrus with teeth on her vagina while she's saying, I got the power, because there's the power. The power is eating what goes into that. Those are the teeth. So obviously that's the agenda. Then let's look. By the way, I'd like to show you guys the meaning of the word Democrat. Democratus, old Portuguese demo means devil, demon. From Latin, demon, god, goddess, divine power. And Kratos means a fishing creel, and it means to weave and to twist together. So demon fishing creel that weaves and twists together, DNA. That's why the Democrats are such freaks. That's why they're a Russian collusion. At the end of this video, I'm going to show you the reason they hate Donald Trump so bad. Don't forget, demon fishing basket, fishing creel means to weave together because it's a woven basket, which is what we are. We're just really a woven basket that a demon occupies. That's it. That's why they use the word Democrat, Demos Kratos, demon fishing basket. See, I'm not making this up. Demo, demon, devil, goddess, Kratos, fishing creel, to weave and twist together. You know, like the Jaguar commercial, we've already created a beast. Now it's time for a whole new animal. What are they selling, a car? What are you kidding? They're not selling a car. They're talking about an agenda that's already in effect. That's what they're doing. Okay, I thought you should see that. I thought that's important. Now, let's take a look at Miley again. Okay, Miley, that's a wonderful outfit you have on. Scooby-Doo is exactly the same as Miley Cyrus. And the bag at Zoomies is the same as Miley Cyrus. And that's all the same as the women marching against Donald Trump. They have vaginas with teeth. And there were many other very telling signs. The ovaries are serpents, and they know it. See, nasty woman, serpent ovaries. Do you get it? Do you understand why the ovaries are serpents? Do you know why the female reproductive system is in the shape it's in? Who do you think the maker of that was? There you go. Okay, so anyway, this would be a come painfully obvious. Here's a really just full of symbology image. This is like a frequency. You see the frequency waves going out. Here's where the all-seeing eye got birthed. There's one ovary that's a right-side-up triangle, other ovary that's upside down, both serpents. It's the serpent system, and out of it comes the all-seeing eye, and they have angel wings over here and another set of angel wings over here, representing the two angel and a demon mixed together inside the host body, sending out a frequency. It's an amazing image, really. It's really quite good. So anyway, there you go. And there's the Women's March, and there's the common denominator between everything is teeth on her vagina, teeth on the vagina. And when you get down to the nitty-gritty of all this, that's the truth. Okay. Okay, pop quiz question. What is the common denominator between the capital of the United States and the Vatican? What do they have in common? I showed it to you when I was showing you dead sheep. Well, let me show you what they have in common. There's the Vatican. The largest altar in the world is a bug with a dead sheep in its mouth, because this whole altar is made of angels. It makes a dead sheep, and there's a penis going in the mouth. And here is the Capitol building right here in Washington, D.C. We'll take the Capitol building and put it right where the brain is. And then right here where the mandibles are of this thing, right here, the mandibles, there is a statue of Ulysses S. Grant, and what's in that statue is a dead sheep. So the capital of the United States of America is laid out in the shape of a bug, and the brain of the bug is actual government, you know, like mind control. How many people know what government translates as in Latin? Gubernamentis. Guberno means to control. Mentis means the mind. Why do you think the Democrats are losing their minds? Because they've lost control of the minds. That's why they can't control everyone with CNN or NBC or ABC or Rachel Maddow. They can't use them anymore. People are starting to wake up in droves, and they're knowing, wait a minute, they've been lying to us. Russian collusion's total BS, total nonsense. Oh, then it's obstruction. First it's collusion, that's an obstruction. The only ones that are guilty of collusion and obstruction are Hillary Clinton, James Comey, Clapper, Brennan, Obama, Sally Yates, Suzanne Rice, and all the people under the Obama administration that were doing all their Justice Department evil lies. So they've lost control now. So the Democrats, the demon fishing creels, are freaking out because they're not in control of the guy that's in the office. You know what? Would you like me to show you why they hate Donald Trump so bad right now, instead of waiting until the end of the video? Then we'll go right back to the insects that are ruling over all the sheep and using the sheep as host bodies to breed their young, which is exactly what's going on, which I've shown you repetitively. But now I'm showing it to you in a way that is just not arguable. Again, by the way, there's a whole lot more. We got probably at least an hour of just images. So let me show you real quick why they hate Donald Trump so bad. It's made very obvious in something here. One moment. Now, remember, the sheep are upside down. We don't know what's going on. That's why when you have an image of the Virgin and you turn it upside down, it's a dead sheep. And the sheep are supposed to be stupid, and they're not supposed to know they're upside down, because that's the way the insects kill them. They make sure once they get turned right side up. Okay, let me clarify. You're born upside down. So in order for a sheep to come to the knowledge of the truth, he has to get turned up. And once he gets turned up, then he can see everything. And then he wakes up. arise as a sleeper, wake up from the dead. And so they don't want any of the, they don't want sheep ruling over them, especially if there's a race of insects that's being run by their boss down in the pit, the angel of the bottomless pit, Satan, the all-seeing eye that's running them all, that's taken over, that's running the gubernamentis mind control. They don't want some wild card getting in the White House that's running the show. Why do you think they're freaking out so bad? You know why? Because he's not one of them. He's a sheep. And they're freaking out that how did that happen? You know how it happened. The Lord God put him in. And now they're panicking. Because, wait, we're supposed to be in control. Let me prove to you Donald Trump's not one of them. He's like I was. Now, do I think Donald Trump is converted? I don't know. Maybe. However, I know that when he made a certain statement, he was not converted, because they said, did you ever ask God for forgiveness? He's like, oh, well, no, I don't ever really think I asked God, but Pastor so-and-so is a great pastor. Doesn't matter how great a pastor you think somebody is. If you never had your moment where you said, I'm sorry, you never got converted. You have to actually be heartfully sorry for the things you've done. And then you get converted. You have to feel that repentance. You got to go, I'm sorry, I don't want to be like this. I don't want to do this anymore. God, forgive me for what I've done. You got to ask for forgiveness. Like the guy on the cross that said, you know, I deserve my punishment. He doesn't. You would be just in condemning me. I said the same thing in my living room. I deserve to go to hell. That's what I said. So unless you've had that moment where you admitted your guilt before God, you're not saved. Do I know if Donald Trump's had that moment since he got elected? Maybe. He sure seems to have a lot going on. And they sure do hate him, don't they? Have y'all ever seen anybody hated so badly? It's kind of fun to watch them freak out. They just freak out. Look at poor Nancy Pelosi. She looks... She can't even make a sentence anymore. You can see the anguish in that poor woman's face. And all these crazies that are coming up behind her, the four horsewomen of the apocalypse. These people, they do as I say, not as I do. And they are the most racist, lying pack of wolves I've ever seen. They're just psychopaths. So, why do they hate Donald Trump so bad? Well, that's made manifest very easily. Resist Trump. You see how they made half of his face dark, making him half in the light, half in the dark. Resist. The T is upside down. Resist. The T is upside down. See the resist right here? That's the devil pointing his finger. There he is. That's just his arm extending his finger pointing. And that's an isotoxal star. Resist. That's a phoenix upside down. The female, remember the pussy hats, resist. The T is upside down. Two of them. They have Trump upside down and backwards. Resist. 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 No problem. Problem. Resist. Turning the logic, the facts, and the American dream on its head. Trump upside down and backwards. That's how you know who he is. Why do you think you have this lunatic Kathy Griffin, who's a complete lunatic, dressed in blue? She's dressed in blue for a reason. And she's got Donald Trump's head cut off. Did you know that insects like in a hive, like hornets, you know they cut the heads off their victim, right? Yep. Isn't that fascinating? Isn't that fascinating how everything just makes total sense now? Now you know why they hate Trump so bad. They make it manifest in all their stuff. They put him upside down and backwards, upside down, resist. Look, signs of the easily fooled. Trump and Pence. See the T and P? They're making a joke like the T is penetrating the P. Get it? I mean, the signs of the easily fooled. This is penetration, guys. This is like the act of sex. Sign of the easily fooled. Get it, T? Yeah. I mean, this is obvious. That's how you know. That's how you know, right there. and they wouldn't make such that they wouldn't be so consistent with their mockery of him with the upside down T unless he was a sheep. And the reason he's a sheep is why they hate him so bad, because they're the devil. And the devil is freaking out. And they are simply a manifestation of that that's going on. Time's up. They know it. And they're freaking out. That's like, oh, he's going to get us all killed. Because, see, they want the world. They think the whole world, they want the world to stay going like it is. They don't want it to come to an end. For us, for me as a Christian, I'm sorry. I embrace and hasten the end of the world. And a lot of people, oh, that's so cold-blooded. No, it's not. Not for me and all my brothers and my sisters. Anyone that's a Christian, that's what you want. If you're not a Christian, you probably don't like that idea at all, do you? Of course not. The end of the world's the resurrection, man. We get to see Dad again. Praise God. Yep. So now that all makes sense, doesn't it? Resist. So anyway, we'll get to some more of that in a while. Again, I'm not advocating for Trump or against him, but I can tell you one thing. He's not one of them. And I do. You know what? I'll be honest. I actually pray for Donald Trump. I do. I pray that God protects him and that God opens his eyes, and I pray that he's converted. Absolutely. He's put up with more shit than any president since I've been alive and that I've ever seen. And, you know, he's obviously trying to make things good for people. And he tells the truth, which is unlike any politician I've ever seen. All right. So anyway, let's keep going. Okay, so now let's get back to part two real quick. You know, now that I showed you the Trump thing, I planned on doing that at the end, but it doesn't really matter. Let's get back to the insects that are ruling over the sheep, that are using the sheep as a host body system to breed their young, because the sheep, the human host body that houses an angel and a demon, is used to birth a race of locusts that are going to come out of the pit, because the cycle from the beginning of the world to the end of the world is coming to an end, and then they get to come up out of the pit. That's what they're waiting for. They're trying to get out. Okay, so now let me show you. So here is the largest altar in the world. I want you to pay very close attention. There's the eye, antenna, mandibles, penis. Okay, so I'm simply going to move that right over here to this young lady that's got a tattoo, and she's got that same thing going on. There's the eye, there's going up the antenna, and there's the mandibles. And you know what I notice about this? And you see those two lines crossing? Swords of Islam. I've seen it before. And then here's another female that's got, it says, Soy la mayor. That means I am the best. She's got a dragon, so obviously the dragon delineates this as well. So she's got the same insect tattoo right above her vagina. So if your penis were to go inside of her, according to that tattoo, your penis would be going into the mouth of a bug. Same here, would be going into the mouth of a bug. Same here, the largest altar in the world. That's exactly what's going on. So they're simply manifesting the exact same thing of the race that's running the show. Now, here's Rihanna. Rihanna's got a pair of stage, whatever these things are, panties, bathing suit, whatever. But that's a devil right there. That's a devil, eye, mouth of the devil. And if you just simply squint your eyes a little bit and you let these be the mandibles right there, those are also mandibles. And it's a bug. So again, the same agenda. Now, here's another thing. Here these tattoos are of the Virgin. Now you can tell it's the Virgin by the outline with the spikes and this orange going around it and the cloak, the shawl over the head. That's the Virgin. But the Virgin is a bug. Why would you have the Virgin being a praying mantis? There's the Virgin again as a praying mantis. Well, here's a girl that's got a praying mantis tattoo on her chest. But if you have eyes to see, I can see clearly that's the eye of a sheep. That's the eye of the sheep. Ear of the sheep. That's the tongue of the sheep. And the praying mantis is hatching out of the sheep as a host. No different than the wasp I showed you earlier. So see, the praying mantis is using the sheep to hatch out of the sheep. See it? So there you go. Again, a host body system, and the sheep is being used to hatch. Very, very obviously. Here's Drew Barrymore. Now, I'll show you Drew Barrymore. And if you look at her, you look at her dress. I'll go ahead and enlarge it. I'll grab my ant head. And she's got just that. Those are mandibles of an ant. There it is, right on her. And where are the mandibles again? So right here is where her vagina is. And there the mandibles are. And so this makes a big ant face. And if you look very closely, you can see these are wings. See the wings? Those are wings. Those are wings, like wrapped around. Yep, it makes several different insect faces. And then if you simply also look at her chest, you see all those little lines? Those are the eyes. Those make ommatidia, which is a compound lens on an insect. So she's just got a dress that's disguised, and it's just an insect in disguise. That's all it is. No different than this girl having a tattoo on her chest that's really an insect birthing out of a sheep. Here is a building in San Antonio. I'll enlarge it for you so you can read. It's a place that used to process deer on Broadway. I used to take my deer there. They have lockers, and you can put your deer that you've hunted in these lockers and keep them cool all year and just go over there and pick up your deer when you want to cook it. So anyway, I used to actually have a locker over there. My brother and I did. And they have hunting supplies, and they do a little, you know, fur and leather stuff. And then you can have your locker there to keep your deer that you've killed. But look right here on the corner of the building. That's an insect right here. That's a bug. So now you have a building that's got an insect on it, on a building that's for hunting. Do y'all remember the building I showed you when I came home from Grand Junction in Eden? The whole wall of a same type building that processed meat and also was taxidermy. It had Eden, and Eve was in Eden, and instead of Adam there was a buck, like a trophy buck. Do you understand the connotation? Being hunted. The Garden of Eden was a hunting thing. So there you go. For those of you who have eyes to see, this is simply a bench that you sit on. It's an insect. Mandibles, eyes. That's a bug. So that's at the car wash I went to the other day. So now you're starting to see clearly that the ones that are the handlers are bugs. Here's the Statue of Liberty represents their liberty from heaven. They wanted their liberty. So if you watch the Miley Cyrus video from the other day, listen to her lyrics. It's my body, I'll do what I want. Because see, that's exactly the thing. I'll do what I want. I've got my body, I'll do what I want. It's mine. Unless you repent of all that, you get to do what you want. But at the end, you get to be food. So here's an image of what the Statue of Liberty, it says the most dangerous place in the world is between a mother and her children, because the Statue of Liberty represents the mother of all the bugs from the pit, all the scorpions that are going to come out. She is a statue that represents the system that she rules over. And right there that she's holding, that's not really a kid wrapped in a flag. That's a bug. So the most dangerous place in the world is between a mother and her children. Who are her children? The bugs from the pit. That's why the Statue of Liberty is standing on top of an 11-pointed star called a hendecagram. A hendecagram is called a kelapot in Jewish Kabbalistic cosmology. And a kelapot is, quote, a shell, a peel, or a husk housing the essence of holiness. Itself is evil, and it itself is inherently evil, and it is part of the Sitra Achra, which is the realm of evil from the other side, the perceived realm of evil called the Sitra Achra. And the Kelapot houses, it's the twin goddess that houses these two different spirits, the good and the evil, in one system. That's what it represents. I've been over it repetitively. You can go look it up. Just go look up the word kelopot. It's in there. Let me see if I have it up here on the top of this thing. Because if I do, I'll just read it to you from the definition. A lot of times in these folders, I put all the links you could possibly need. Let's see. Time Machine, Rolling Stones, Flocks of Sheep. Nope. It's not in this one, but it'll be on one of them. So, okay, I'll just show you a few more images now. Here's a tattoo on this young lady, and she's got a girl's face, and what's coming out from behind the face is a praying mantis, because that's the truth. What's really behind the illusion of the host body is an insect that's hunting you. That's hunting. We're being hunted. And those of them that aren't like us, those of us that are the sheep, well, they'll say, oh, you're crazy. Oh, you're nuts. No, 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 no. I've got all the data to prove I'm not nuts. No one can argue with this data. It's data. It's empirical data. Largest halter in the world is a damn dead sheep. It's a penis. It's a vagina. It's a bug. It's a dead sheep. The building it's in is a damn snake. I've got a video of a guy standing inside the snake singing Lucifer donning his own creation, which is Genesis 1 verse 2. It's exactly correct. So this is not arguable unless you're delusional. So if anyone's trying to call me delusional, I'm sorry. I've already passed 3 MMPIs. My results were unremarkable. That means no one can try and make the case that Jonathan Kleck is mentally deficient in any way, shape, or form. As a matter of fact, if you try and make that case against me, you just made it against yourself, because I've been proven 3 times to be completely not mentally deficient. Therefore, if someone's trying to make the argument I am, they are the ones that are mentally deficient, or they have never taken an MMPI. There you go. Now, again, here's the same agenda. Female insect. I am Shadow Hunter. Well, I'm sure you are. Here's the Grateful Dead. This is a band I used to really like to listen to. If you pay attention right here, that's the corona of a penis. That's the glans penis. And that right there is something coming out of the glans penis. And this thing that looks like the sun, those are really sperm around an egg. And it says the Grateful Dead. Do you know why their name's the Grateful Dead? They're making fun of us that we are the Grateful Dead. Oh, this is so wonderful, you idiots. It's not wonderful. Not when you wake up, then you'll realize you don't even want to be here. Because once you wake up to the truth, you quit loving the world and the things of the world. Wow, that's exactly what the Bible says. If you love the world or the things of the world, you have not the love of God in you. Once you have the love of God in you, you hate the world. You don't want to be here anymore. And then everyone's like, what's wrong with you? How come you're crazy? No, I'm actually awake in the evil system that they're not awake in yet. That's all. Or they're one of the bad guys. One or the other. It's that simple. So anyway, so there's a Grateful Dead. Just prove that. Shadow Hunter in training. Now, isn't that fascinating? Shadow Hunter. Because, see, they truly do hunt from the shadows. See, you would never know that this girl's really like being run by an insect from the pit, and that she's really just out to take men to the pit. What puts you in the pit? Fornication. If you're a fornicator and you haven't repented of it, you get to go to the pit. So if you're having sex with that young lady and it's all fun, yay, this is great. You think you're having a great time? Well, it may be fun for, just like the Bible, the pleasures of sin last for but a season. But in the end, they lead to death. There's a way that seems right unto a man, but in the end leads to death. Right? Okay, so let's take a look again. Okay, there's just very obvious. There you go. There, we've seen that. We've seen that. Here's a very amazing image. This is art. I saw this a while back, and it's a woman. It's like a skull. One eye's open. There's a locust coming out of one eye. Cicada, whatever. Oh, by the way, I want to clarify something. They always use insects that have a pupa and a nymph stage. That's why the word nymphomaniac is there. A nymphomaniac is used to describe a girl that's hypersexual because she's actually in the nymph stage. Because she's hypersexual because what's running her is a nymph. She's in a nymph stage. The final stage comes out of the pit. Understand? Again, unless you've been converted, you're one of them. That's all there is to it. Well, let's take a look. She's got vampire fangs. She's got a mouth full of pills because she doesn't know why she needs all these different pills. But something ain't right. And then this stitching, it shows that she's really got a suit of skin that's stitched on, but it also makes a sperm, doesn't it? And then look right here, a tattoo on her arm, like of a moth or a butterfly. Perfect. Absolutely perfect image. And then if you look right here, here's an image of the Virgin right here, but you see the two skulls down here, it makes an insect head. There's the eye, there's the eye, there's the proboscis. So, again, we have a common denominator with these insects, don't we? Let me show you some skateboards. Now, these skateboards are, there's a character in a movie called Mars Attacks, the Martian, but they use the same imagery and art as the Virgin. See all the little wavy lines? That's the Virgin. They dressed her up in the cloak just like the Virgin, but it's really a Martian. It's really an evil, malevolent being hidden. And then look what's coming out from under her. Oh, wow, a locust. Coming out of the pit. That's identical. That is literally identical to the list of popes right there. Look at that. It's identical. And it's the Virgin. Well, at the Catholic Church, the Vatican, who do they worship? The Virgin. What are you looking at? The Virgin. What's coming out from under the Virgin? A locust. Okay, in the image of actual image of the Virgin, you know what that would be coming out from under? An angel. Do the math. It's very simple. Okay, so there's not just one there. They have another one. This one's red. And I'll just enlarge it so you can see it. There you go right there. See, there's the red locust coming out. Now, here's a really fascinating one right here. I want to show you this. I'll go ahead and knock that out. Just knock out some of these windows. But right here, watch this. This is fascinating. Okay, do y'all know what that is right there? Y'all know what that is right there? That's the sigil of Lucifer. I'll prove it. Watch this. Let's do Google Images. Okay. Sigil of Lucifer. See, I'm not lying. I've done all my homework. There's the sigil of Lucifer, and there's a skateboard. Let's just grab one of those sigils of Lucifer and go, oh my goodness, the sigil of Lucifer right there on the skateboard. What's interesting about this sigil of Lucifer there is it's got a, instead of one V, it's got a W. Watch. Fascinating. Really fascinating. Look at that. See her leg right there. V and V, W. They know they've completed the system. So anyway, so as we just keep going around, look. Original sin. It's a female. See? Original sin. Let's see. Here we go. This is for Apple. This is original sin hard cider. Let's see. XX plus XY plus apple. Get it? Let's see. S-I-N-H-E. Sin here. See, that's capital S, little s. Capital L-I, little I. Capital N. So, S-I-N, sin here. Okay. XX, that's male sex chromosome plus, female sex chromosome, XX. Plus male sex chromosome, plus apple, they're saying, plus their cider, okay, equals original sin. There you go. Got it. So, this is just so obvious now, it's ridiculous. Here's the Beast system. This is exactly correct. This is a very famous painting. I think it's, I want to say Bocelli, I believe. But here's the system. One going in the mouth and the other one coming out upside down and is making the W. That's why they put his arms like this. One U, another U coming into the system and he comes down. One's coming out and one's going in. That's the system. There you go. Yeah, I believe it's Bocelli. It's a very famous picture. Very famous painting. And so, you know, by the way, let me just clarify this. Just so you know, the Beast system, if you look at the vagina, it's also a face, which is very common. They do it all the time. That's why these girls have these tattoos of sheep and devils and all kinds of stuff. Medusa right there at their vaginas with the mouth open, so your penis would be going in the mouth of Medusa and all these other things. It's very common. Okay, there you go. Scroll through this. Okay. CIA challenge coin. This one's classic. Usque quamque, usque quamque, cognito secos numquam cognito basium. Each one learning by never learning a kiss. Usque quamque, cognito secos numquam cognito basium. Okay, so it's a guy that's whose identity is fully cloaked, but this is an obvious giveaway. You see the infinity symbols on the bottom of the sneakers and the way they did the lines there? That's because to see the truth, you have to turn this upside down. So when you want to know the truth and you see something like that, you just simply have to turn it upside down. And we'll turn it upside down and we'll see each one learning by never learning a kiss. And we've already seen Eros and Psyche. So when you turn it upside down, oh, it's a bug hatching from a pupa. And I'll simply take this and put it right. Oops. And enlarge. Let's try it again. I'm sorry about that. Okay, here we go. So I'll take this and then I'll enlarge the one coming out of the pupa. And bam, there's what's going on. So, because of the kiss, each one learning by never learning a kiss, because of the kiss, a race of bugs is hatching. Here's Lord of the Flies. He's being stung by a bug. Here's an apartment complex in San Antonio. Okay, you see B? That's two, but look, that's a bug. Those are the eyes. Eyes, proboscis. So, if you have eyes to see, here's a strip club in San Antonio called Level, L-E-V-E-L. Get it? L-E, what's L-E backwards? E-L, and see the V representing the five that's them. Five, V and V, five and five. Okay, and then when you take these two cells and they intersect, they form a vesica piscis. That's why the Washington Monument is in the intersection of the two circles, representing the two cells that intersected, the first two cells starting the system, the male pronucleus and the female pronucleus. Boom, boom. And this represents the penis of Osiris. It also makes the all-seeing eye. That's why a MasterCard has this, because that's your master. The intersection of the two sets has become your master, male and female, in the same system. Let me let that enlarge, and then we'll move on to the next. There you go. See, MasterCard. There's your master. The intersection of the two. Okay. So, I'm going to show you a quick Simpsons clip where they redid the intro for The Simpsons, and they have Maggie, the little girl, going across the scanners, and they scan her, and I want you to look at all the numbers that are on the screen when they do it, but I want you to look at the system. Her mom is an insect, and she rings up Maggie, and she takes her and puts her in the basket, and then the little boy turns into an insect. He hatches out of a pupa stage. Watch. So there's Mr. Burns. He grabs Smithers and he eats him. And then it shows. Now, every number looked good and bloody. Bleeder's Digest, Better Tombs and Gargoyles, The Ghost of Newsweek. Now, the number 23 right here, the number 7 means to perish and destroy. The number 50, I have it in the folder. I'll show it all to you. And watch, she goes through and she's rung up. She goes through, what's ringing her up is a bug. You see the number 5 representing V, you know, the V, Roman numeral 5. That's just written out in 5. Now, watch this. She goes over the scanner. And when she goes over the scanner, her number is 666 because she's in the flesh, puts her in the basket. She's got the 50 on her. She looks at the little boy. He's got 75. 75 means to contend as in a contest. And then watch what happens to him. He splits and then she becomes him. So, I mean, you know, none of this would make any sense unless you know what I know. Now that you know the truth, all of this makes sense. Everything has purpose now. You understand? We are literally a slave race to a race of insects that use the host body to capture angels to transmute them into food so they could get their energy, send it to the pit, and come out of the pit and make war against the Lord God. And it was a female energy that was the culprit, I should say. The female energy, the female spirit is in opposition. That's why when you pray to the Virgin, you turn the Virgin upside down. It's a dead sheep. That's why Proverbs 25 says, it is the glory of Elohim to conceal a matter. Everything I've shown you is something that was concealed. So Elohim concealed it. Jesus doesn't conceal anything. Jesus, where his light shines, it reveals everything. So let me go over Proverbs 25 real quick with you, because I want to put this in there just so everybody understands this. It's very important that people understand. Jesus does not conceal anything. Jesus reveals. He sheds light on. Oh, I'm sorry. Proverbs 25, verse 2. Okay, it is the glory of Elohim. Look, it is the weight properly of Elohim. Gods of the Supreme God, angels. So that's the same thing as Genesis 1. It is the glory of Elohim to conceal, to hide by covering, literally to conceal, to hide self. Okay, y'all remember the Sistine Chapel, the guy holding the suit of skin, and he's part of the face of the dragon, the guy holding the skin suit. You remember the Scion commercial, the little deviants with the X on their face that scares the sheep, and the sheep jumps out of his skin, and the deviant puts on his skin, concealing himself. What do you think is concealed? Do you think it's something good that's concealed? It's the glory of Elohim to conceal, to hide by covering, conceal self. But it is the honor, properly weight, of kings. A king, but look, we all, the Bible says we will live and reign as kings with Jesus forever and ever. Ready? It is the weight of kings to reign, to inceptively to ascend to the throne, because we will all ascend to that throne that have been called causatively to induct into royalty. So it is the honor, the weight of kings, because we will be inducted into royalty to search out, look, to search out, to penetrate, to examine intimately, to find out, to search out, to seek out. Let me tell you something. That is not a female spirit that seeks it out. It's a female spirit that hid it. Wisdom. They hid wisdom. Be as wise as a serpent. The serpent's very wise. And we have to seek it out. and it is the honor of kings to search out the matter. A cause. There you go. Very interesting, isn't it? Okay. So now, again, the mechanism. Now remember, the host body, think of the host body as no different than the roach that that jewel wasp stung. They needed a host body to get the transformation of an angel, which is a light being trapped. When you trap it in that host body system and you couple it in there with a demon, then you have a mechanism to convert the angel. Because if he dies in that host body without getting converted back to his original state, because there's dual energies, there's opposing energies, male and female, opposing everlasting chains of darkness, forward and backwards ligaments of the body. And that's what the Kelepot stands for, the 11-pointed star that the Statue of Liberty is standing on. That's why they call it the Statue of Liberty. It means their liberty from heaven to have host bodies and do whatever the hell they wanted and to scoff at God. So that's what that's why it's called the Statue of Liberty. Now, this next section I'm going to show you, you're going to see all these young ladies that have transmutation circles, which is the center part of a hendecagram, which is what the Statue of Liberty is standing on. It's a kelepot. It means shell, peel, or husk. Like a shell, like your body is a shell. It's a peel. It's a husk. It's a host. So what I'm going to show you now is all these women that have tattoos of transmutation circles, which is what a hendecagram is, and they all have bugs because they know the transformation of that angel results in a bug from the pit, a locust, a scorpion. Watch. So here it is. Now, I'm going to give you some definitions. Definitions only make you smarter. Transmutation, the action of changing or the state of being changed into another form from angel to locust from the pit. The transmutation of the political economy was post-war was complete. Physics, the changing of one element to another by radioactive decay under nuclear bombardment. The conversion or transformation of one species into another. Now, that's called a transmutation. Now, just to show you, so you can see with your own eyes, I like to do this, you know, so people can see transmutation circles. So you can see the variety of geometric forms that transmutation circles take. See, there they are. I mean, this is the same one they used at the Rio Olympics. That was the perpetual motion machine that was the clitoris, which the whole stadium was a vagina. And this is what they used at the top, and it was a perpetual motion machine. And these are all transmutation circles. All of these are. That's what these are. Transmutation circles. Look right here. See the dragon, the Ouroboros? Look what's in the middle. Right side up, upside down triangle. These are just the telltale base, most understandable geometric designs in understanding what the enemy is trying to do with the angel. And the transmutation circle is represented by the 11-pointed star, the hendecagram. And I'm gonna pick a part of one of these, and I'm gonna show you exactly where it is in the hendecagram. Watch. We can take the Ouroboros right here. We can take this one. We can take a variety. We can take this one. We can take. I like the Ouroboros because here you go. Right here, there's the circle with the upside down sigil of Baphomet in the middle. Or even the one I showed you with the Ouroboros, the dragon, wherever it went, with the right side up, upside down triangles in the middle. There it is right there. See, right in the center, right side up, upside down triangles. Okay, so now let's go to here. Okay, so I put one right here. Transmutation circle. So here's what the Statue of Liberty is sitting on top of, an 11-pointed star, that building. So, but what's right in the center of it? There you go. That's what's in the dead center of it. Well, what's in the very center of that? A five-pointed star. Okay, now, remember I told you the system is five and five. V and V, five and five. Hey, peace, man. Hey, peace to you. W. So they're taking one of God's angels, which is a right-side-up star, and they're simply turning it upside down to an upside-down star, and an upside-down star is the sigil of Baphomet, the Church of Satan. So they take an angel, turn it upside down, it becomes the Church of Satan, the Temple of Satan. That's it. It's that simple. So here you go. Let's take a look. Here's another one. See, look. See, there's a star in the middle, dragon going one way, dragon going the other way. It's the dragon system. Well, once it makes a 180, what happens to the star? It turns upside down. Here's this young lady. She's got the transmutation thing right on her back. Look, right here, there it is. That you will absolutely find on these people's tattoos, you will find exactly the geometric design in right, like right here. There you go. You'll find all these designs that are on their backs right here. There you go. Right there. There it is. And here you go. What's the common denominator? Bugs. This one has a lizard right here. Reptile. Cicada. Cicada. See the X? That's the V and the V put together. 5 and 5 is 10. Bad girl. Cicada. Cicada. See, that's the crescent moon. Birthing. Cicada. Transmutation. Cicada. Cicada on top of these hexagrams. Okay, look at this. Mirror. Get it? Her reflection is a cicada. It's a bug. She knows this is a transmutation. Same thing here. Transmutation. Cicada. This girl is like an angel. Looking in the mirror, it's a demon. Same thing. This is just a cicada hatching from its shell. Look at this. Cicada with a lightning bolt representing lightning from heaven. So I beheld Satan as Barack, lightning from heaven, Barack Obama. So transmutation, all-seeing eye, mirror, cicadas, Ouroboros, cicada. It's always the same, mirror, cicada. Cicada, all of it's the same. Look at this. I mean, this is just stunning. And here you go. Here's the Vatican. Here's the serpent wearing a crown. Do you know why it's wide there? Because the serpent's pregnant. It's a pregnant serpent. Do you know why they made the whole patio out of black cobblestone? Black cobblestone resembles black serpent skin. Look. Look at this. See this? That's serpent skin right there. That's why they made the whole patio out of black cobblestone. So everything proves out and shows itself for what it truly is. But you have to be able to see it and understand it. And you can't see it and you cannot understand it without the Holy Spirit in you. Otherwise, you're just one of them working for them, or you're one of their slaves, one or the other. You're either a fully functioning hunter, or you're a slave in the system being hunted by a fully functioning hunter. Or you get converted and you're like me and you're no longer welcome here, and the whole world rejects you and hates you because you've been converted. And then they're all against you. You're crazy. You're a lunatic. You're this, you're that. But I can prove all day long I'm not crazy. I've got all the records to prove it. And I'm the one showing you all this information. The information doesn't lie. I mean, is the Vatican a snake or no? It is, isn't it? Is the largest altar in the world a dead sheep? Yes, yes it is. Is the largest altar in the world not only in a dead sheep, but a male and female reproductive systems? Yes, yes it is. Is it also a big bug harvesting semen? Yes. So anyway, so it's all correct, so everything I've shown you is correct. So I've shown you facts that equal reality. So I'm showing you the truth. So no one can argue with it. Otherwise, they're delusional. They hold on to their own idiosyncratic belief, even though I'm presenting evidence that proves to the contrary, whatever their belief is. I'm showing you the truth. It's right in front of you. There you go. Okay, let's do a few more. Okay, you've seen this one. I just really like this image, though. I cut it out really well. Look, the most dangerous place in the world is between a mother and her children, because the Statue of Liberty represents the liberty they took from heaven, and that they wanted their own thing, their own host body system. And so the Statue of Liberty represents the liberty of the angels they took from heaven to have host bodies. Again, here's the waxing moon, full moon, waning moon. That's the life cycle, like, of a human. And that's very common in witchcraft. Again, here is a girl with a cicada with one wing out, representing one half that can fly, the other half's getting ready to. Here you go. Cicada. Why would all these people put cicadas? Look at this one. A cicada holding on to these two telephone poles. This is a double cross, by the way. Satanic cross. That's where it's getting the energy from. Here's a guy with a big cicada on his chest, and that crescent moon right there represents the birthing. See, it's on and on. The same identification marks pan out every time. Here's this girl. This is called the death moth. This is like the thing that was used in Silence of the Lambs. And on the back of the moth is a skeleton. See it? A skull. Red leg. All-seeing eye, crescent moon. There you go. So, I mean, these are just fully functioning hunters. That's all. That's what you're looking at. And they're just manifesting what they are in tattoos on their bodies. And Daniel 12, the time of great trouble, the time of trouble is the time of female rival. And then Daniel 12, it says, ever since there was a nation, the word nation means flight of locusts. I mean, you know, you couldn't even make this stuff. You couldn't even think this stuff up. See, there shall be time of trouble, 16:8, 69, flight of locusts. I'm sorry, time of trouble ever since there was a nation, 14:71, a flight of locusts. See, not making it up. It's all completely accurate. All right. Let's go back. Okay, sorry, I'll try not to waste any time. I'll pause this. Okay, so there's a Statue of Liberty, and she's holding a penis in her hand. The flame is a scorpion stinger. She's on an 11-pointed star, which is a kelapot. A kelapot represents, it's housing the essence of holiness, and it is inherently evil. It's a peel, shell, or husk. Inside, in the very dead center, is a 5-pointed star. So when you turn a 5-pointed star upside down, it becomes a sigil of Baphomet, the Church of Satan. So their goal was to get an angel, which is represented by an upright star, which is what you see in the middle right now. And then when you transmute it, it becomes an upside down star. And that's the system that we're caught in. And that's their goal. Turn a star upside down. A star is an angel. And here you go. Here's a perfect representation of it. So there's an angel, you get it caught in the transmutation circle, you turn it upside down, and it becomes this food for one of these in the pit. There you go. And that's what's happening. That's what's going to happen. These will all hatch. They'll all come out of the pit at the same time, and then that's when all hell breaks loose on Earth. That's why you have Eros and Psyche, an angel kissing a woman. It's really a dead sheep. No doubt about it. Not only is it a dead sheep, but look, it's an insect stinging an angel, and it's dragging the angel. Look, see the angel's foot right here? It's dragging the angel down an underground hallway, and its abdomen's coming around. I just didn't color this part in right here. And it's stinging the angel. So the mouth of the woman turns into a stinger, stinging the angel. And it's dragging him down this hallway, no different than a scorpion wasp. And that happens to be just like H.R. Giger's xenomorph from the movie Covenant. I mean, you know, there you go. All right. I'll tell you what, guys. I'll show you a couple more. There is a dress at a very expensive dress shop in the Galleria in Houston. It's a bug. I, mandibles. Why would you have a big bug on your dress unless it's true? Again, same agenda. This is St. Stephen's Cathedral right here. You see the spear tip going towards the open hole that represents the penis and the vagina. You turn it upside down. Let me show you what's on it. It's a bug. There's the eye, and the mandibles. It also makes the female reproductive system. There you go. It's also identical to the Jaybird. Jaybird is a very popular brand of earphones, headsets. And I'll put it right there. It's the same rudimentary image. There it is. Jaybird. And the term Jaybird, like naked as a Jaybird, it comes from when prisoners were taken to jail. They were stripped naked and they were made to walk the line in front of the other prisoners. That's where naked as a Jaybird comes. And they're making fun of us because in the Garden of Eden, they became naked. They were clothed with nakedness. They were clothed with garments of nakedness, because they were light beings, and then they got clothed with serpent skin, which made them naked. There it is. Just staggering, isn't it? Anyway, I like this one, City of Waco. The City of Waco right there, it's a V with the star and a V with the crescent moon, and you turn it upside down, and it's 9/11. It's identical to 9/11. They had a king over them, the angel of the bottomless pit. Look at the star. It turns upside down into the sigil of Baphomet. So that's the crescent moon birthing Satan. There you go. And by the way, that's Islam as well. So they've taken over. All right, guys. Do y'all know who's harvesting all the sheep now? Has it become abundantly clear why this girl's got a Venus flytrap and she's putting it over her mouth, shooting the devil horns? Because it's true. That's why. That's why this Venus flytrap has a sheep in it. That's a sheep. That's the eye. That's the ear. That's the head of the sheep. That's why several girls have different Venus flytraps. That's a sheep. That's a sheep. Sheep are what's to be destroyed. All right. Guys, I could go on and show you lots more bugs. But I think you got the point, don't you? Let's go back and reread the thesis sentence and then we'll call it a day. The conquering race would also more than likely exhibit manifestations that also identified them as the rulers. What would those manifestations be? The virgin would portray itself as an insect, which is what it really was. That was the way to begin the system. Insect. Insect. There it is. Okay. And what's coming out of the pit? Well, guess who's coming out of the pit? They had a king over them. Satan, Apollyon. Who had a king over them? The scorpions that are going to come out of the pit. So Satan will be unleashed on the earth with all his army of insect race. Xenomorphs, scorpions. Has anyone seen one error in this entire presentation? There's no errors. Everything's perfect. The data's perfect. Not one thing stands in opposition to another thing. It's 4:10 in the morning. Oh, that's perfect. L, the Almighty God. I'm going to end it at 4:10. All right, guys, peace and grace. Johnny the Legal Eagle has presented another caseload of evidence, and the jury, when they come in, I don't think can find any other way but for Mr. Kleck and his presentation. All right, guys. God bless. And I'm going to get back to my regular clothes. And then I've got to show y'all what happened coming home from Grand Junction. Yes. Consecrated potter's clay. We've been consecrated by faith. All right. God bless. Before I sign off, I flip to another folder. I just want to show y'all a couple more pictures that are super duper important. So let me just show you these. Remember, there's a cloning line called 400, and it really means hunted for dinner. And that's why on one of the sweatshirts, there's an angel up here, because angels are hunted for dinner. So he serves that race. Now, the number 400 in the Strong's Concordance, it literally means prey or food. Look, see, prey, food supply. The definition of the number 400 in the Bible, it means food supply, mealtime, and prey. So if you have a clothing line called 400, it means prey. And the way they did it, it's hunted for dinner, and it's got an angel. Okay, so this is no longer hidden from our sight. No one can argue with this. But let me show you something fascinating. I want you to look at this girl's back and just think about this girl got this giant praying mantis like it's exiting out of her entire back. And now look at this drawing right here of this young lady taking off her blouse while this guy is sitting back on the bed going, all right, this is going to be great. I want you to look at the shadow that she's casting. This is the exact truth. That's the way you're hunted for dinner. And it's, by the way, it's not just females hunting males. Both males hunt females, females hunt males. You can be a sheep and be a female. You can be a sheep and be a male. That's, no one knows who's who and what's what. Anyone ever saw the Star-Bellied Sneetches by Dr. Seuss? That's a good one. Everybody wanted a star. So there it is. And so this is just absolutely perfect. And, you know, here's another just amazing image, is just the reality of what we're dealing with. There's Lady Gaga wearing her dress at the Oscar Awards. She's wearing a bug. That's an insect. It's also turns into a serpent. So anyway, this is across the board. It is consistent. It's the same. It is not arguable. And there you go. So anyway, but I really wanted y'all to get to see this image right here. This is just so powerful. Her shadow is a praying mantis. And here's a girl with a praying mantis on her back. So, you know, if you're sleeping with her, I can guarantee you she's connected. Absolutely. So anyway, there you go. And that's why Drake has a tour called, album called Scorpion. And at his concert, he has a big scorpion that comes out of a box because they had tails like unto scorpions, because he's part of the above ground eyes and ears of the scorpion race below ground. That's all there is to it. So, who's hunting the sheep? The scorpions from the pit. Who are the sheep? God's angels that were carried away captive. And then, not only carried away captive, but they are exiled because they sinned against the Most High. So, they got carried away captive into the system. They get coupled with the demon in a host body. If they don't get converted, born again before they die, they don't get born again of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, and that takes over the host body. Then you go into the pit, you become food for one of them, and that whole race exits the pit at the end of the world, and they have their little time on top of the surface, and then all the other plagues start hitting, and it sounds like no fun to be here. I'm a harbinger. Okay, there you go. Information delivered. I'm going to get back to like regular Johnny. I'm pretty tired of being Johnny Lawyer. Okay, there it is. I tried to deliver it in a way that if you want to show anybody this information now, so here's the thing. I've used complete logic. I've been very calm. I've delivered it in a way that's very professional, very lawyer-esque, as if I was in a court of law. I gave you the data, gave you the facts, and I put all the stuff together in a nice package so that no one can argue and say, oh, this guy looks like a Fruit Loop because he's wearing a D-rag. I really don't care how I look. But I'll become all things to all men, so some might get saved. So if you want to show this to the people who are harassing you and saying, oh, you're crazy, well, I'd like to see them say I'm crazy. Not going to work. All right, guys. I love you. Love you in Christ. Super tired. Group hug. Sorry. I'm freaking exhausted. I'm so tired. Now it's 4:22. I'm whooped. All right, guys. God bless you. 4:22 Saturday morning. And I'm going to call it a day now. I love you guys. And please just think deeply about this information. Go get all the folders. Go look at all my folders. Try and go through every picture that I've gone through the time to post for you. It'll blow your mind. By the time you're through with all the pictures, you'll have an understanding that's so profound, no one will be able to sway you away from the truth. And anyone that's teaching the Holy Spirit is a female, pray for them. Because they drank their own Kool-Aid. God have mercy. All right. Take care. Bye-bye.